Hello everyone, this is Anson from AnsonAlex.com, and in this video I'm going to show you a potential solution to the error on macOS 10 High Sierra when you try to update an app in the App Store or purchase a new app and it says could not connect to server. That message, when you click cancel, is followed by the message we could not complete your request. Now I was experiencing this issue for over a month. I tweeted with Apple support back and forth for a few days trying to fix it, tried a number of different things, and I finally found a solution, but it was kind of an obscure solution that I'd like to share with you. But before I do that, let me just close this out here for a second. I do want to make sure that you've tried all the basics, which I did try first, just to make sure that it's not something a little more simple that is holding you up. So first of all, definitely make sure that you try multiple internet connections, try restarting your computer, and then also try going into the App Store, and you can go to your homepage here, and go to where your account is over here on the right side, click on account, and then just sign out of your account. As you can see, I'm not fully signed in right now, but sign out of your account, sign back in, and make sure that you are connected to the right country's app store. So whatever country you're currently in, I'm in the United States, so you can see I'm connected to the US app store. But make sure you're in the right country app store, and just go ahead and sign out and then sign back into your account. If you've done all that and you still are unable to fix the issue, let me show you a couple things that may help. So I actually tried these two solutions at once. I'm pretty sure it was the second one that worked, but I'm going to show you both just in case you need to do both, or in case one works for you that didn't work for me. So what you need to do is, first of all, go ahead and just go into Finder and click Go, and then Go to Folder. Go ahead and type this path into your Go to Folder window, /var/db/crls/. That's going to bring you to this folder called CRLS. These are just some database libraries that are cached in your system. Safe to say that you can delete these out, and if they need to recreate themselves, they will. So go ahead and delete whatever files are in here. There might be different files. There might be a second one as well. You can see I deleted mine not too long ago when I resolved this issue. So go ahead and do that first. Empty your trash, and then you can restart your computer, or you could just go on probably to step two here without restarting your computer. Now, step two is what I believe fixed the issue for me. And in order to do step two, we need to access Keychain Manager here on our computer. So I'm just going to hit Command Spacebar. And type in, I'm sorry, it's Keychain Access. I'm going to type in Keychain. You could also just go to your Applications folder and find Keychain Access. It might be in the Utilities folder within Applications. When you get into Keychain Access, you've got a bunch of different areas here. And you'll notice that I blocked out some information because this is where all of your passwords are kept, right? So I blocked out some information in the login section here in Keychain Access. But where we're going to be accessing to fix this issue is the System Roots section. So just click on System Roots, and then you can really just have all items displayed. I found some different solutions in the forums talking about different certificates that you might have to look at. But safe to say, let's just look at all of them. And then what you're going to do is you're going to scroll through this list. And you see I've got a bunch of different certificates in here. And you want to find one that has a blue outline around it. It actually looks a little bit different than this blue outline. But for me, this is the one that I needed to find, this Developer ID Certification Authority. It was untrusted previously on my computer. So what I did is I double-clicked on this certificate to get this window to open up. And then I click on the Trust dropdown. And what you want to do is, under Secure Sockets Layer, SSL, make sure that it says Always Trust. Previously, mine was set to No Value Specified. And then what you're going to do is you're going to, now this is very particular, so make sure you kind of do this in the right order here. Once you change this to Always Trust, go ahead and close out this window. You're going to have to enter your computer's administrative password to apply those changes, so go ahead and enter that password. Then go ahead and double-click on Developer ID Certification Authority again, or whatever certificate is highlighted in blue for you. You want to make sure it's like an Apple certificate, that it's nothing sketchy, but safe to say, if you're having this issue, nothing has worked, there should be a blue certificate in here related to Apple that you need to trust. So we've done the first part. Now we're going to go back to trust and just make sure that it says when using this certificate that it's set to use custom settings. Then go ahead and close it out again. If you have to enter your administrative password, go ahead and do that, and then restart your computer, and that was it for me. That worked. So if I go into my App Store and I go to my updates, you notice that these updates were installed in the last 30 days, installed June 5th, today's June 5th. All of these things finally updated today after I used this keychain access solution. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. If you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.